Hello, friends. I'm Pastor Pitts Evans. Welcome to the Whole Word Podcast. Let's get right to the Word of God. Friends, when I introduced the Psalms initially, I told you that they are divided into five sub-books that correspond with the books of Moses. The first grouping corresponds with Genesis, second group of Psalms corresponds with Exodus, and so forth. So today, we begin the fourth book of the Psalms, which corresponds to Numbers, and that consists of Psalm 90 through Psalm 106. The first of those Psalms in this division is Psalm 90. It is authored by Moses, interestingly enough, which would make this the oldest of the Psalms, or certainly among the very oldest of the Psalms. The occasion is unknown, but it's basically a beautiful prayer dialogue that Moses reflects with the Lord back and forth about Israel, and Moses interacts with the Lord as Israel's intercessor, as he so often did in the days of leading Israel. So let's read now Psalm 90, a prayer of Moses, the man of God. Lord, you have been our dwelling place through all generations. Before the mountains were born, or you brought forth the whole world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn people back to dust, saying, return to dust, you mortals. 1,000 years in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. Yet you sweep people away in the sleep of death. They're like the new grass of the morning. In the morning it springs up new, but by evening it is dry and withered. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. All of our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with a moan. Our days may come to 70 years or 80, if our strength endures. Yet the best of them are but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass and we fly away. If only we knew the power of your anger. Your wrath is as great as the fear that is your due. Teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Relent, Lord. How long will it be? Have compassion on your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love, so that we may sing for joy and be glad all of our days. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years as we have seen trouble. May your deeds be shown to your servants, and your splendor to their children. May the favor of the Lord our God rest on us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. So a beautiful psalm, friends, penned, as I said, by Moses, or spoken by Moses and recorded by some unknown scribe. But if it is indeed, as it's purported to be, written by Moses, and we have no reason to doubt it, this psalm would be today somewhere around 3,500 years old. Now think about the wisdom that was contained in this 3,500 years ago. And so it's a prayer of Moses, and he begins by proclaiming that the everlasting God is our dwelling place. He says, Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, you brought forth the whole world. From everlasting to everlasting, you're God. That expression, before the mountains were born, you brought forth the whole world. Friends, in the natural realm, the mountains remind us of our finite nature as human beings. Compared to a human being, a mountain is eternal. But compared to God, a mountain is as a human being. In other words, mountains are finite when compared to God, but they seem infinite when they're compared to us. The everlasting God is far, far beyond the age of mountains or the possible lifespan of the mountains. And so Moses contrasts the finite nature of mortal man with the infinite nature of the living God. He says, you turn your people to dust, saying, return to dust, you mortals. 1,000 years in your sight are like a day that's just gone by, or like a watch in the night. A watch in the night is a prayer segment, a segment of time for prayer at night. Continuing verse 5, yet you sweep people away in the sleep of death. They're like the new grass of the morning. In the morning it springs up new, but by evening it's dry and withered. And once again, comparing plants with very short lifespans to humanity and our very short lifespans in comparison with our infinite God. And so he goes on to speak about the fact that our sins are not hidden from the Lord. He says, we are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. All of our days pass away under your wrath, and we finish our years with a moan. And so he essentially is saying that nothing is hidden from God, that due to the brief lifespan of mankind, we should seek to live godly lives. He continues with what some have held to be a definition of the expected lifespan of mankind. He says, our days come to 70 years or 80 if our strength endures. In other words, you can expect 70, but if you're in really good shape, you might get 80. A lot of people take this as a promise for our mortality, for the years of our mortality. He goes on to say, yet the best of days are but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass and we fly away. If only we knew the power of your anger, your wrath is as great as the fear that is your due. In other words, the Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. If we knew the power of his anger, we would live differently. Moses goes on to ask the Lord to help us, to teach us, to show us how to get the most out of our days. He says, teach us to number our days so that we may gain a heart of wisdom. What beautiful words those are, friends. Teach us to number our days so that we might gain a heart of wisdom. And I say amen to that. I assume you do too. He goes on to ask the Lord to have compassion on his servants. He says, relent, Lord. How long will it be? Have compassion on your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love so that we may sing for joy and be glad all of our days. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years as we've seen trouble. And then he asked the Lord that the Lord's children may come to know him and his ways better. He says, may your deeds be shown to your servants, and may your splendor be shown to their children. Once again, I say amen to that as well. And then he closes with a blessing and asking the Lord to let his blessing rest on us as his sons and daughters. He says, may the favor of the Lord our God rest on us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, may he establish the work of our hands. And so much to agree with in this Psalm of Moses. And I just want to pray into some of these things. Lord, we do pray with Moses that you would teach us to number our days so that we might gain a heart of wisdom. Help us to live in the fear of the Lord and the awareness that our days are quickly passing. Help us to make decisions that make sense in the light of eternity. Let us make each day count for you and for your eternal kingdom. And Lord, with Moses we say, please have compassion on us as your servants. Satisfy us with your unfailing love. Lord, may you reveal yourself to us and to our children and to our children's children. And may your favor rest on us. Lord, establish the work of our hands that we have endeavored to do for you. Lord, establish the work of our hands as the work you would have us to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for listening to this episode of The Whole Word. It was brought to you by Whole Word Fellowship and the Northern Virginia House of Prayer. If you were encouraged, please share our podcast with your friends. We'd also appreciate it if you'd hit subscribe in your favorite podcast app and take a few moments to write a review. If you'd like more information on our church and our ministry, you can go to wholeword.net or wholewordpodcast.com for more information. Thank you again, and may the Lord Jesus bless you today and always.